4.0, by the way. Can you help me understand what do you know when we heard about a term like marketing 4.0? What do you think? See, no one is judging anyone out over here. So let's be as interactive as we could. So Kishore Keshwani mentioned it's digital marketing. All right, Kishore, anyone else has got any opinions? So your interaction with me will be your energy. Perfect. Akshay Pawar, you said it's in 4th era. What 4th era, by the way? So as I told you, your energy, your interaction, your responses back to me will be the only fuel, because if I have to converse with you for 2 hours, so it would be very important that you will have to keep me charged up, by the way. The smartphone only will be smart if there is a adequate amount of battery being picked up. Okay, so let's get started on this particular topic. So before I move on to this particular thing, couple of disclaimers I like to make is I will not be talking anything specific. I will be talking in general. Okay, so you might have to draw down the references. You might have to draw down references from the communication I make over here. Okay. So now this is a first slide. This is a first 5 minutes of putting up your footprint onto digital platform. That's the reason I said it's a journey to create your digital footprint. Okay, so we all are on social media. We are on WhatsApp, we are on smartphone, and we are on emails, and we are across everyone. So which essentially means ki hum logo ka digital footprint already had been put up there. But point is that, is my footprint being used by marketing agencies outside, or I am also using a marketing footprint of my customer, is what we are talking about. And this topic is very relevant as of now for one particular reason, is we are in a COVID situation. We have seen a last lockdown, how it has disrupted lots of businesses. Okay, and I'm sure now next lockdown is also being spoke in country, in the world, and we don't want to be getting disrupted. Rather, we want to be a front runner in terms of change and transformation. That's one of the reason why this topic of marketing 4.0 is very, very relevant in today's economy. Okay, so let me roll. So it doesn't make any sense, right? Investing in and for this particular webinar without understanding what is that you are going to take away. So what is that going to be a takeaway of your session is I am going to discuss on a fundamentals of marketing and a branding. Do you think it makes sense? This is what you are here for. One of the takeaway is going to be fundamentals of marketing and branding. Second is we are going to talk about traditional versus modern marketing. So traditional marketing is what we had been seeing, what our parents had been seeing, and day to day when we go and buy or we sell, it's called traditional marketing. So we are going to discuss upon a difference between traditional and a modern marketing. Then we are going to talk about ki what are the tools and technologies are available today in order to ensure that we are just not educating ourselves, but we are using it. For multiple reasons, okay, which I will also talk about how you can acquire more customer, how you can engage with your current customer, how you can brand yourself, how do you get more business inquiries, and multiple such kind of dimensions. So how many of you are interested in tools and technologies? Just type TT. How many of you would be interested in knowing what kind of tools and technologies should be used? Just type in TT over here. Wonderful. Then we are going to talk about now, see what had happened is with this COVID situation, there's also a full reset of a mindset of the people had gone in. So our habits are no more the kind of habits what we had in last March, right? The way we are buying, the way we are selling, the way we are consuming a content has got changed drastically. So now what does this mean is there's a new generation. There is a new mindset of people out there who now want you to serve as per the new mindset. Now today people want to see, people will consume the same content what they were consuming. People are still buying clothes, they are still buying gadgets, they are still going and eating out in a restaurant, they are still going and staying in hotel, but the way in which they are accessing all this information has got changed. So today people are buying, but they are buying more from online medium. People are eating out, but they are getting more takeaways at the homes. People are still transiting. So take an example, Ola and Uber, people don't trust anymore because you don't know where is this COVID going to be sitting. So which has given an immediate jump to an automobile sector because today everyone wants to transit in their own vehicles. Am I making sense? Are you with me? And is my pace okay with you all? If you want me to be lower on the pace, I can do that. If you want me to be fast or if you're good with this, perfectly all right. So as I told you that this entire session is meant for you. It's not meant to show you what all I know. Okay, so even if this could be around couple of slides, even if we are at fifth slide, but we are getting engaged into good amount of discussion, I think that's worth it. Okay, no point in looking up at those slides. So my point over here, even if you are able to take couple of 4 to 5 takeaways in this particular thing and implementable action items, I think your investment will be paying off to you. Okay, and second thing is like with post-COVID-19, customer behavior has got changed. So which means that the way I sell, the way I buy, the way I produce, the way I communicate, okay, it could be product, it could be services, it could be tangible, it could be intangible, okay? So which means that now without using technology, I'm repeating, without using technology, you will not be able to deliver. So take an example right now, if there are 73 members in this webinar, this is happening because of COVID. Otherwise, do you think it would have been possible for all 73 people, someone from Delhi, someone from Hyderabad, someone from Switzerland, and someone from USA to be a part of this? It wouldn't have been possible. So now this has reset everything. So what does that mean is everything that was conventionally existing is now being challenged and now being disrupted, right? So let's get started with this particular session. So I was just trying to build up the agenda of this particular session. So we all are good to go with this. So let's get ahead. So now when we talk about a terminology of marketing 4.0, so this is a buzzword, by the way. Okay, it's like calling haldi ke doodh ko cafe turmeric latte. But it makes more sense to understand what is this marketing 4.0 has got us for us. So marketing 4.0 essentially means that now here we are dealing with a more modern mindset, more modern and technology generation. Here we are dealing with the people who are changing conventionally the way they were using, they were consuming the content. So now try to understand on one particular side, if there's a technology generation, and on the other side, if we are still trying to sell them traditionally, there is going to be a conflict because they will buy, but they won't buy from you. Do you ever see a discussion saying like, let's ban Amazon, let's ban Flipkart, and let's ban these and that kind of thing? Because it says that it is not promoting local market, it's not promoting local trader. But had we been able to do that, and we will do that. See, when I am selling to a traditional marketing, I don't feel that this modern marketing should exist. I think it is challenging our conventional thing, it is challenging our economy. But understand one thing, that this is a new generation, this is a new mindset, this is a new technology era. And if we are not aligning our footprints on digital, we will be disrupted from market. Okay, so now let's try to understand. So I am not going to talk about tools and technologies only. Though we are talking marketing 4.0 is all about technology and the data, but what's the point in understanding tools and technology till the time we don't understand? So it's a mindset game. So now we all know that in today's era, your data is a king. So it's a saying that if you can't control your data, you can't control your business. Okay, so can someone help me understand that? Did you get a clarification when I say if you can't control your data, you can't control your business? Can anyone put up your viewpoint? What does this mean essentially? Please put up your viewpoints. What does this mean? If you can't control your data, you can't control your business. I'm waiting. So there are lots of business owners. I have seen the profile of the members. There are lots of CEOs, presidents who are a part of this. So let's try to interact. Okay, so I am nowhere claiming I am the expert. I am only going to talk what I know, okay, with my knowledge, because this is changing so drastically today. So what is relevant today might not be relevant tomorrow. Yes, so it says customer based business, consumer profiling, data is a, so let's take an example. If you can't control your data, you can't control your business. Okay, so we all are using smartphones. Okay, so my contacts is now a data. Now, if I can't control my contact, I can't call up my connect also. Second thing, Ola, Uber, your app stores, okay, or probably a Fire Stick. So they are giving you. So do you know one thing, that when you go to YouTube and you try to access one particular video, then YouTube itself starts recommending, saying that you might like this. So which means that every footprint, every behavior, every action you take on a digital platforms basically creates your persona. And based on this particular persona, relevant information is being sent across to you. So now that is more from this particular technology. So point over here is, are your business inquiries being stored as a right data? Are you sending them an email at very frequent interval? Are you keeping in touch with your prospective customer? Are you acquiring new customers from digital platform? Are you collaborating your SMS inquiry, your WhatsApp inquiry, your inquiry from your website, inquiry from your Facebook, inquiry from your LinkedIn, inquiry from your Twitter, inquiry on the YouTube, and multiple such kind of platform into one singular database? So do you have a CRM? How many of you have a CRM implemented in your organization? How many of you claim that you have a full control over your data? How many of you think you have a full control over your data? If you say you have a control over data, type I control, else say I don't control. So Shweta Singh said, I have CRM in my organization. Now, most of the organization have a CRM, but are people using a CRM? It's like buying an iPhone by paying 1 lakh rupees, but using a feature of 10,000 only. Okay. So if you are not using, don't worry. We are going to discuss how to control your data, how to consolidate your data, and how to implement a CRM. Though this particular system is, I'm not going to discuss about how to implement. That's a different session altogether. But I will like to put up a very strong emphasis on one thing, that there is a need to consolidate all your data at one place so that you can use your data as and when you require. Okay. So now when I talk about this particular topic, so what is marketing 4.0? So we discussed marketing 4.0 essentially means it's a collaboration of a data and a technology. So when your data and your technology collaborate, it creates an opportunity. So Amazon uses you as a data. They don't know your entity, but they only know you as a data. And then they use a technology of their platform like e-commerce to sell you product. Ola, when you try to book, okay, accesses your data, who you are, what is your past record, where are you standing, and based on that, they send their cab across to you. Similarly, when you go down to Zomato, or when you go down to Google, or when you go down to YouTube, what happens is, they consider you as a data, and based on your consumption of the data, they will try to give you another set of the data. So now we as a marketer need to do what? We need to use a marketing 4.0 so that we can generate a business inquiries. Okay. The objective of business is to do business. And in order to do business, what we have to do is we have to generate a business inquiries, right? So point over here comes is, how many of you are using digital as a platform to generate business inquiry? Can you write down, I generate? If you are generating business inquiries regularly, adequate amount, just type I generate, else say I don't. Wonderful. Akhilesh, fantastic. Kishoji, you do. Jitendraji, you do. Okay, 14 is not yet. Okay, no worries. Okay, so by and large, we do generate. Okay, my reply to this is, we do generate business inquiries from technology, because if you have a website, if you are on a portals, if you are on Facebook, you do generate. But point is that, are you generating it consistently? Is a business inquiry generated by you through digital platform sufficient? If you think it's sufficient, just type sufficient. If you think there is a scope, you say still there is a scope. How many of you are generating business inquiries which is adequate, sufficient? Not regular. So that's one of the challenge, because most of us know the potential, but we are not using it to an adequate. That's the reason that if my capacity is to deliver 100, I only generate a business inquiry of 25. Okay, which means that 75% of my potential is untapped. Am I making sense to you? Are you all with me? Are you all with me? Perfect. So we need to collaborate a data and technology so that we can generate business inquiry. Second thing, how many of you have a department which is called data mining and marketing department? So which essentially means that there is a team who generates a database from internet of your potential customer. You store it up in one of a software which is called CRM, and then you reach out to them through email, through WhatsApp, through telecalling, or by doing a remarketing kind of campaign. How many of you are having a control of your customer database, now customer, prospective customer database? Do you generate, have a department or a person who generates, whose job is to generate new business opportunity every day by doing a digital marketing? Wonderful. So someone is saying, we have a department. Akhilesh is saying yes, Shweta is saying no. No worries. So what it means is basically there is a need, because see, your car is only going to work when you have a fuel. Okay, there could be a driver. So now this data, okay, is a fuel. Okay, this technology is your car. Okay, and you are a driver. Now in absence of a car, what do you do with a fuel? And with fuel, but no car, what do you do? So we, by and large, we all have a driver, but either we miss a bus, or we miss a car, or we miss a fuel, right? Second thing is your technology doing an automated customer follow-up, which means that does your CRM gives you an alert that you need to contact a person on this particular date? Do you have a control of all inquiries being put up into some kind of a sales automation system? Now see, in absence of this automation system, what will happen is you will be sitting on a gold mine, okay, without understanding a prospect. So we don't want to be beggars, okay, having a golden cup in my hand and asking for that. So we all by and large are having that particular potential. So point over here is that when we have right kind of a data, we use the right kind of a technology tools, okay? So that this data and technology gets collaborated and it automatically, yes. So someone said have used HubSpot. That's wonderful. So this is where we have a mix of people who are using technology. So now HubSpot is one of a platform wherein it automates all your inquiries together. It gives you reminder. It gives you a lot of business understanding level. Because if you have everything great, but if you don't have a platform or a technology which is a custody of this particular data, then that particular data is called spilling data. So it will fume out. Okay. So now those days of CRM. So earlier definition of CRM was called customer relationship management. Now that definition has got changed to customer retentionship management. Okay, or prospect retentionship management. So now when you start using this particular technology, what happens is you can get in touch with your customer periodically. So there could be a couple of people whom you want to connect with them on a weekly basis, with someone on 15 days basis, with someone on a monthly basis, with someone on quarterly basis, and something like that. With someone you like to get in touch with them on an email or SMS or WhatsApp. So now when you use the right technology, what it does is technology gives you a lot of insights. So I might tell you one particular example of a platform called Cow, okay, which I use it up. So what happens is I had installed this particular app on my mobile phone, and my mobile phone then does what? It connects with all my contacts, and then it says with this particular contact, how frequently you want to be connected. and it gives me an alert. So which means that I don't miss out my customers or my contact birthdays, anniversary, follow-up dates, or probably an passive and active kind of anything. So the name of that particular thing is called Curve. Just a minute, I'll just type it out for you. So while I will be talking to you all, I will keep putting up some contacts over here. So just keep a record of that. C-O-V-V-E. It's an app, okay? So once you download this particular app, it collaborates with your contact and then it asks you to put up a relationship with that. So it's pretty standard kind of a thing. I don't want to take too much of time, okay? But start using this particular software. It's an amazing contact management system. On my mobile phone, there are 4,500 contacts, but only 40 or 50 or 70 contacts are something which I use it upon day-to-day basis. What happens to other contact? Because I don't know. So which means that everything what is going to make me rich is sitting out over here, but I don't know how to use it. So a technology platform like Curve is going to help you with that, right? Second thing is it helps you to do a communication. See, now everyone doesn't require the same kind of communication. So are you able to categorize? So once you start using it up, what happens over here is you can divide your data into saying that customer, competitor, future customer, then you might call it up as a colleague. Okay, so, and what happens once you do that thing, you can customize your communication strategy from time to time basis. The kind of communication you want to make with your customer, you won't like to make it with your competitor, right? Otherwise, if you treat data equally, so what might happen is through any of the channel, let it be email marketing or through LinkedIn marketing or through Facebook marketing, the same content will reach to your competitor and your competitor will be exactly knowing what you're doing in the market. And I'm sure you don't want them to know about it. So you should be able to categorize all your contacts accordingly. So I have a software which we use, but I don't want to take that up thing right now. If I have time, I'll just show you how do we manage all the data. Okay, today we had almost close to 200 registration, of which 74%. So generally ratio today is 33% people attend. So they are here and what I had spent, I had not spent anything. None of people who had registered, I had contacted them. I had not spent a single money on reaching out to all these particular people. Yet I have 74 members who are attending and 200 others who had known about me and 60,000 people who had got this particular email reply from me. Am I audible to you, by the way? It's been long that I haven't heard a voice from you. I just thought I'll just check it up. Audible? Thank you. Okay, am I aligned with every one of you or am I deviating from your thought processes? Am I talking too technical? Perfect. Then second thing is like, when you have a good amount of technology and data and your technology is able to segregate your data, saying that customer data, prospective data, competitor data, future customer, past customer, happy customer, not happy customer, okay, a CXO level customer. What happens is you can improve your communication and sales and marketing campaign accordingly. So the kind of communication which you can send it to your CXO level, CEO, CTO level people will be something different compared to what the kind of communication which you will be sending it to your customer. So I'm sure with your new customer or prospective customer, you would like to offer them some kind of an offer. But if the same email goes down to existing customer, it would damage your current billing, right? So that's one of the reasons why a relationship is required to be established. Why a relationship is required to be established with your data. So you should exactly be knowing what is this data and what is your relationship with the data. So that at a time when you want to market, when you want to use it up, okay, it should be very, very apt, right? So when you have this particular thing, what happens is, and when you are coupling this particular thing, so your customers will be recalling you because it will not happen sometime out of a blue, you call up someone. So because now you are making consistent communication with your customer, what happens is your brand gets recognized. Customer doesn't forget you. Tomorrow he want to use your services, he want to refer your services, he immediately remembers you. Okay, how many of you think your customers are your biggest source of your referral? Do you think your customer is the biggest source of your referral, right? Now, question to ask yourself is, how many referrals your customer gives you in a yearly basis? Now, if your customer is only buying from you but not referring your name to someone else, it essentially means that he only remembers you for his references, but when it comes on to referring anyone else, he forgets you. Then what is required to be done is you have to ensure that your customer don't forgets you. And for your customer not to forget you, just don't sell them sales letter all the time. Send them some kind of a value proposition. Try to create some kind of a case studies. Try to create some kind of a white papers or blogging kind of a platform or something like that. Okay. And then once you have a data, you can emerge as a thought leader. So take an example. If you have seen my email, so everyone out here had probably registered through a web link which was being shared to you. Okay. So you have seen me, you have seen my photo, you have seen my poster, you have seen my company logo over there. So what happens is a visibility has got increased. And with increased visibility, what happens is your brand reputation goes up. Do you think with increased visibility, your brand reputation goes up? Type reputation goes up, if you think so. Okay, so which essentially means that you should be consistently visible among your network at any given point of time. Okay, so let's get started. So this is how we all had been doing marketing until now. Okay, traditional marketing. This is all decade old marketing, okay? Or you call it marketing 1.0, marketing 2.0, or marketing 3.0. We are talking today about marketing 4.0, okay? So traditional marketing, when we talk, is a location of brand centric. Ki when I will only be able to sell it through my store, through my physical shop, through my physical factory, through my physical showroom. Yes? And second thing is, it is very local. You have to be very competitive and your reputation has to be strong, because if you are not competitive, a next door is your customer and he is competitive. So which means that you sell a lot, but don't you don't make a lot. You sell, you have a lot of customer coming to you, but the margin is very, very thin. Do you think your margins are thin and having a thin margin will help you grow your business? It won't, right? It's not a question also to be asked. Second thing is with traditional marketing, your repeated customer is 80% and new customer is only 20%, because only those set of customer comes to you who are within that geography, who knows you. Now, this is one of the danger game, by the way, which means that your growth doesn't exceed more than 20%. Okay. So which means that because of your physical boundaries, okay, you are not able to attract, because no new customer will be able to walk on to you at that frequently. So research says that with the traditional marketing, 80% of your customers are local. They are repetitive. They come because of your reputation. Only 20% new customer you are able to generate on yearly basis. Are you all with me? Or you say you beg to differ? Perfect. Second thing, traditional marketing is person driven. If I am there, I will be able to sell. If I am not there, people will not buy from you. If sale has to happen, Ashish Dalia has to sell. If Ashish Dalia is not there, sale is not going to happen. Had you ever seen anyone from Amazon, by the way? Had you ever seen anyone from Flipkart? Had you seen anyone from Ola or from Zomato? Had you seen anyone trying to come and sell it to you, but you buy from them? So which means that with a technology and with a digital marketing, it really doesn't matter who is selling. Important is that the sale has to happen. The sale has to be efficient. It is not person dependent. It's process dependent. Traditional marketing is person dependent. Okay. Traditional marketing, person goes with a mindset of planning and having a budget in mind. Okay. Which is need based. So when I feel hungry, I'll go to hotel and have. Okay. If I'm not hungry, but when it comes on to Zomato, you are just browsing Zomato and you see one offer, you buy. Right? You are just going on your Facebook and you see some advertisement coming from Amazon, you buy. All right? Second thing is, it requires a decades to build up your reputation. Now we don't have decades, by the way. We don't know how's the future going to be there a year after. What are we talking about 5 years? So you don't have that kind of a luxury of the time right now. So which means that not traditional, we don't have that luxury. So our parents, our grandparents had built it up. It was good for them, but not for us. Second thing is, you only work 8 hours a day, which means that you pay rent for 24 hours. You pay salary for 24 hours. Your light bills are being paid for 24 hours. But your shop, your showroom, your factory is open only for 8 hours. So which means that as it is, you are diluting your opportunity by using, paying 100% for the resources, but only using 33% resources. Wherein in case of digital is 24/7. Your WhatsApp doesn't sleep. Your website doesn't sleep. Your email doesn't sleep. Your mobile doesn't sleep. Okay. So, and second thing is, it's a reference and the recommendation base. So I asked you a question sometime back. So only when your customer refer to you, you have a new customer, because walk-in customers are in generally where we are. So now let's talk about modern marketing. So what do you think modern marketing will have an advantage to? Can you please write down a few of the advantages for this modern marketing? I'd like to hear from you. While I grab a sip of water, I want you to give me a break and just please type in. Perfect. So someone says immediate response, fast and reliable, always see new customer, track effect. So now, one question for everyone out there is, when you know so much of it, what is stopping you from doing? When you do so much, when you already know so much. So I don't think probably you have written more pointers than what I was about to present. So my question over here is, when this crowd is so elated, they know everything, what is stopping you from doing? My question has got changed, Vishalji. My question is, what stops you from using modern marketing? Convincing top manage for the ROI. Okay, Prava. I agree with this particular point because I know that, yes. So Praveen Deshmukh from Accludes, the knowledge, so many offerings. So you say there, the knowledge and so many people are there to offer. Okay, anything else? Lack of knowledge and training times. Okay, don't know exact process. Okay, fine. I think everyone is right. Let's move on to with this. So modern marketing is, you can regulate. How do you want to be operating? You want to be local player. You want to be regional player. You want to be national player. You want to be global player. Okay, there is a very, very clear demarcation. So when you are on digital, so I want to send my email to my local customer, my regional customer, my national or my global. Second thing is, with modern marketing, required is a great amount of branding and visibility, because you don't touch, you don't know from where you are buying. If your if your organization is not a brand, if your product is not a brand, if an owner of a company is not a brand, okay, people will not buy from you. So branding and visibility is important, because people are going to buy your product through digital platform. So which means the digital reputation of you, your company or your product has to be very, very high. Have you ever seen who's a Apple person coming and selling it to you? Or had you ever seen anyone from Samsung coming and selling it across to you? So they are people who are using a great marketing tools of modern marketing. So they will show you everywhere, but they will not send any person. And when you don't employ a person and you employ a machine, machine is more effective, right? Compared to a person, and machine doesn't sleep. So modern marketing essentially means that a advantage of modern marketing is 80% of the customer who comes to you, buys from you, they are new, and only 20% customers are old. Do you agree with this philosophy? See, the flip side of traditional and modern marketing is the difference between, in traditional marketing, 80% is a repeated customer and 20% is a new customer. In the modern marketing, 80% is new customer and 20% is repeated. Now you imagine, now here is an opportunity for people who are into traditional marketing to adapt a modern marketing. So what does that mean over here is that so people who are running up their shops, showrooms, services through a physical delivery, if they also put up their footprint onto modern marketing platform, what will happen is they will go drastically because they are present even in physical and even on a digital platform. So physical platform will give them that 20% new customer and modern marketing will give them that 80% new customer. So imagine one thing, which means that year on year, there would be 100% growth when these two things are being collaborated together. Do you all agree with this? Do you agree with this? Yes. And what I'm talking over here is a data, by the way, it's not from me. Okay. So believe me or not, you have to believe it. All right. Second thing is modern marketing is purely a process and a technology driven. Because if you are not having a process and if you are not integrating it with a technology, you will not be able to sustain. Okay, because in modern marketing, everything is happening through a system, through a technology, and technology is not a human. Okay, it doesn't have an error. So when it doesn't have those kind of an error, it essentially means that it will have to be system and process. So if it works for one, it will work for everyone. So when Ola and Uber says you that from destination A to destination B, it says you will reach there by 8:20. You will reach there by 8:20 or 21 or 19 only within a buffer of 4-5 minutes of the gap, because there is a process and there is a technology. When Amazon says you that your product will be delivered to you at the time when you shop at this particular date, they ensure that it gets delivered because there is a process and then there is a technology. So when we are using so much of it, how is traditional marketing going to align? Wherein we say, I don't know. So when you go and buy, he says, when am I going to get the product? I don't know. Let me check. Even if they check, we don't get it at the same time. So understand one thing, modern marketing is ruling out all inefficiencies of the system. Okay. Second thing is modern marketing is omni-channel. Do you know what is omni-channel, by the way? This is something new. Can someone just type in what is omni-channel? What is omni-channel? Yeah, it's a question. Online plus offline. Yeah, Jinesh, yes. Anything more? Anything more? Multiple channel. Shweta, what does multiple channel means? Variety plus multiple channel. Digital marketing. Okay. So omni-channel means that I am into sale of something. The same content is available across all the platform. So take an example. If I sell this particular bottle. Okay. So this bottle is available in my showroom. This bottle is available in my shop. I am selling this bottle even on Amazon. I am selling this bottle even on Flipkart. I am selling this bottle even on Snapdeals. I am selling this bottle even on Facebook. I am selling this bottle even through my WhatsApp business account. I am selling this WhatsApp even on my Paytm mall. So which means that the same bottle can be bought by a person across any channel. Or probably take an example while I'm speaking to you right now over here. Let me check. So while there are 79 members over here, it's also getting broadcasted live on my Facebook. And let me check how many are there. Just give me a moment. So this is called omni-channel, wherein while I am with you over here, I'm just checking, okay? So this is also been seen by a couple of people on, just a minute. So this is also been seen by, I am unable to go over there, so I'm not wasting time. Okay, so essentially it means that people on my Facebook are also going to see. while this session will be over, but the same video will also be available on YouTube, so that people who have missed out, they can check it out there. So people who are not on YouTube can see it on Facebook. People who are not on Facebook can also go and see it on LinkedIn, but can also see it on my Instagram as well. So what does this essentially means that my same piece of content is available across, so that the footprint of my product is coming to various channels. If we are able to understand it, I'll tell you 20% of this session is achieved. You follow this omni-channel content. So here comes a 20% of your learning. Don't be present on one shop. There was an old saying which says, don't keep your eggs, all eggs in one basket. So similar is the thing. Don't try to do business from one basket. Do you think you made worth investment of your time until now? So we are like 45 minutes as of now. How would you rate this 45 minutes interaction? Please rate it on a scale of 0 to 10. How would you rate your investment of 45 minutes on a scale of 0 to 10? Wonderful. Thank you. Chalo, let's move ahead. Second thing is, with modern marketing opportunities, that impulsive buyer. So a buyer doesn't go with a mindset of buying one. He goes with the intention of buying something, but he buys a couple of more things because of the offer. Now, this doesn't happen in a physical traditional sale, because traditional sale, if I have a budget of 1,000 rupees, okay, if I have a budget of 1,000 rupees, I cannot spend more than 1,000 rupees. But on a modern marketing, I can pay 1,000 rupees on COD, cash on delivery. Second thing is, I can pay to credit card. I can pay it even through an EMI. Do you ever remember any shopkeeper or any store giving you an option saying that you buy from me and pay me on EMI? But technology is making that particular thing to happen. And apart from this, that more you buy from them, more stronger becomes your digital reputation. More stronger become your digital reputation. Basically, more offers you start getting. So I'll cover that thing in some more time. So it's all offer based. It's a convenient of a communication. So modern marketing gives you a very good edge, because you can be very creative when it comes on to communication. So when you go on social media, when you go on YouTube, what you see is a bundle of creativity. Okay, and that's only possible on modern marketing, because today, if I want to make any communication, I cannot afford hoarding. I cannot afford to go on television. I cannot afford radio. I cannot afford newspaper. But today, I can afford Facebook, Instagram, LinkedIn, Twitter, YouTube, WhatsApp, and whatnot. So when so much is available to me, it essentially means that I have a convenience of communication through my channel. So believe me, one thing, I had not spent a single penny in terms of getting 200 people to register and 80 people to be a part of this, because I use modern marketing. So imagine one thing, people who are into manufacturing or people who are into services, who used to spend lakhs of rupees into exhibitions. How many of you used to participate in exhibition, by the way? Just type in over there. I have very good research to talk on. Wonderful. Kishoreji, you know. Yes. Okay. Yeah. Please carry on. I would like to hear out. If you are attending, say VILC, you say no. So we see most of the people over here are participating in exhibition. Now with this COVID, exhibitions are not happening. Exhibition cost a couple of lakh rupees. Exhibition is only for 3 days. A person next to you is also your competitor. Customer don't come to buy. They just come to roam around. So exhibition is not giving that kind of a revenue. And with this COVID situation, what I'm trying to do, try to understand one thing, I am participating in digital exhibition. So if 79 members are here and looking at me and staying at my stall for 2 hours, which means that which exhibition do you think will be able to give this kind of a return? Do you think exhibition will be able to give this kind of an ROI? Do you think exhibition will give this? And without investing a single penny. So now my another objective. So I am giving you another 10% of learning today. Start investing into your data. Start investing into making a mechanism the way I'm making right now. And start inviting your potential customer on a webinar the way I'm doing it right now. And every person who comes to the webinar, try to give them one particular dinner voucher free of a five-star hotel. It costs you probably 2,000 rupees. But for this 2,000 rupees, when a person comes and stays for the full session of yours, and if you pay 2,000 rupees, I'll tell you, this is 20 times more profitable avenue to you compared to any exhibition. Am I making sense to you? I just made one strategy. This was not a part of my script. Do you think what I spoke to you sometime back, I'm repeating it again, collect all your data, put it up into system, what system we will talk, shoot out an email, make a presentation the way I am doing right now, have 20, 30, 40 people attend your workshop, and if they attend it for the full session, give them a dinner voucher, give them an Amazon voucher worth 500 or 1,000 rupees at the end of the session, and I will tell you, this will give you more better return on investment than international level exhibition. Are you all with me? Are you all with me? Yes. So I think I'm just missing out. I have one report. So it doesn't make sense, because in an exhibition, you never know whom you are going to meet. Absolutely, Kishore, that's bang you are on. Because going and participating in the exhibition is like a daydreaming. Okay. Shooting out bullets in a dark, assuming someone is going to die. Okay, but because people are not educated with modern marketing, then what happens is I have to do something. And what is that I can do is only traditional marketing, right? So this becomes another 20% of the learning of today. Invest into data. Invest into data. Are you now convinced that you need to invest into data? You need to categorize your data. You need to sort out your data. You need to put up a relationship to that particular data, that this data is my customer, potential customer, my employee, my ex-employee, okay, my south customer, my north customer, my real estate customer, or my manufacturing customer, or something like that, right? Chalo. Second thing with modern marketing is, like, with modern marketing, one of the biggest disadvantage, people don't have a strong memory. In traditional marketing, people have a strong memory. In modern marketing, people don't have a strong memory. Probably in a morning, in one of the WhatsApp group, I liked something and today I forget what I like. I only know one thing. Yeah, today I saw something in my WhatsApp group. I forgot which group, what was the content, and it's difficult for me to track. So which means that modern marketing requires continuous effort of publishing content on internet. Because if the only way of reaching out there is through digital platform, is through digital content. So if you are not innovative with your content, what's going to happen? People will forget you. So what was presented yesterday was relevant only for yesterday. It's no more relevant today. So you have to be a bit more innovative with your communication strategy. So in short, what we understood is that modern marketing is equal to digital marketing. So what is modern marketing is a question to me. See, these days I generally get confused, because school from home, our kids also sleep. And probably either they are influenced by us or we have got influenced by them. So I would like to see a camera on by everyone right now, so that I know that I am just stopping presentation for 2 minutes so that I can see a camera of everyone. And I'm only going to... So please keep your camera on so that I know that I am talking to real people. Oh, wonderful. Everyone is so great. So I am loving the energy by all of you. Thank you. Thank you. It's always a pleasure to see so many faces in a room. And the best part with this is without a mask, right? Perfect. So now let me continue with the presentation again. So that was just an icebreaker, by the way. Okay. So now let's talk about why is digital marketing trending? Because it is smart. So when I say smart, okay, management people might know a definition of smart. I'll run it very, very faster because it's specific, because with your communication, you can be very, very specific. Okay, you can measure whatever you did. So today, if I shooted out 10,000 email, I can measure by the end of the day what has been the result out of it. It can be achieved because the data, if it's being married to a real user, so you can achieve. Point is that how innovatively you are. Second thing is, this is not realistic. So we probably 10 years back, if I would have discussed with you that if you wish to go somewhere, you have to just press one button and car will come and pick you up. It was daydreaming, right? But today it's not realistic. Probably a couple of years back, if someone was asking, I wanted to buy clothes, so only way was to go to shop. But today you go online, you see something, 3 days down the line, clothes come to you. So it's not realistic, by the way. Today, finding out any information sitting in any part of the world is possible because of this technology. It's realistic because Google, YouTube does it all. Today, you want to find out information about any particular person, you can dig out the information of the entire history and geography of that particular person. Okay? And second thing is timely. So there is a time for everything. Okay, if my audience is, take an example, if I sell toothpaste and if I try to send my promotion material in afternoon, it's not going to sell. So my right time for doing that one thing would be either late hours or evening time when people go and buy toothpaste. If I run a restaurant, doesn't make any sense of putting up advertisement at 4 o'clock or probably 7 a.m. in the morning. There is a time, right? A timing like 12:30 to 2 o'clock is the best time to show up the advertisement over there. So there has been a timing. So this works on a data, right? So when we talk about digital marketing, so let's try to understand what are 9 pillars of digital marketing. Would someone would like to put up, by the way, I have put up one particular platform. What could be these 9 platforms for digital marketing? I'd like to hear it out from you, audiences. What do you think makes a full package of digital marketing? So website, SEO, SMM, Facebook, Insta, perfect. What else? It's YouTube, okay. Application, all right. Please continue while I grab water. Perfect. I am feeling so great that I am sitting with so many elated people out here. You are making my life so easy, by the way. Okay. And I feel that I am just coming over here and making a revision of it. In fact, so thanks a lot that now I feel a sense of achievement that I am talking to a very right set of the audiences. Okay. So I applaud on behalf of everyone. Give me thumbs up. And this thumbs up is to all of you. Wonderful. Well, let's go ahead. Okay. So when we talk about website, so website is a basic chassis, fundamental of a digital marketing, because all digital marketing base is a website. Ola is a website, Uber is a website. So even though you access it on mobile, but the base of that is a website. Amazon is a website, Flipkart is a website, and Google is a website, and YouTube is a website. So everything is a website today. So yours is also a website. So you are also Amazon of your own businesses. So here comes and things. So application is also a website, right? So when we talk about a website, what makes a website is a domain name, email address. So I see a lot of people making a big mistake that they use @yahoo.com, @gmail.com. See, when you are seriously in a business, be serious in a business and have your own business domain name and have that particular email address. So if my website name is ikf.co.in, I'm just putting it in the chat form. So my email will have to be this. It cannot be Ashish@gmail because then it's not a serious entity out there. Second thing is that when I use email signature, that should also be a branded email signature. Now, your website user interface and user experience plays very, very critical role, because if your website is not mobile compatible, if your website doesn't loads up faster, if your website doesn't have a fast downloading speed, if your website menus are not good, then this website, instead of bringing customer to you, they will ensure that your website runs away from you. I am saying you, so it's like a sword, okay? So either it's going to kill your enemy or it's going to kill you. So be ready when it's a lethal weapon. So when you are going and trying to go and win the world over there, first thing is that your digital vehicle, it's like a flight, by the way. You cannot board an aeroplane which is half cooked, half prepared, or half serviced, because it is going to kill you. So Praveen, you say it's two-edged sword. No, it's not two-edged sword, it's single-edged sword. Either it's going to kill your competitor, or else if your competitor's sword is more aged than you, then he's going to kill you. So your website is going to be something like that. So write user interface and user experience. So I'll just show you an example, okay? Your website should be mobile compatible, because 70% of the people today are trying to check a website on the mobile phone. So if your website is not mobile compatible, doesn't load faster on a mobile, the entire digital marketing game is off. So it might be like you are driving a Mini Cooper, but the chassis of that particular Mini Cooper is like a tractor. Okay. And now we have come up with a new concept, which is called talking website. How many of you know, by the way, what is talking website? So these are the two things I'm sure you had never heard it before. I'm going to talk on that. How many of you know about a talking website? Does it seem interesting? Do you want to see what is talking website? Perfect. So we are a company who had innovated one thing, which is called talking website. Okay, so for talking website, I will have to just stop my screen sharing. I will have to start it again with my full view. So I am going to show you something. So this is my regular website, right? Can you see my website? Just put it up in chat if you are able to see my website. Okay, so now what we did innovative was, like, a human, when he comes, he can read the content of the website. But these days people don't want to read. It's an era of YouTube, it's an era of Tata Sky, it's an era of Fire Stick, where everyone wants to see visual and hear it out. So we said, why only influence customer with one thing? So person who can read, but if person is not able to read, then what to do? So we said, why not we make a talking website? So we made a talking website. Okay, it's in the experimental phase right now, but we had just done a pilot project today only. So I'm going to show you an example of that. And we had put up this talking website concept on this particular page. Okay, so do you see this icon? So person who wants to read this particular blog can any which way read, but person who don't want to read a blog, what he does is, let's see that.
More than a billion hours watching YouTube.
Are you able to hear?
It comes to around 100,000 years, which is more than all of human history in a single day. That's startling, isn't it? In addition to YouTube, video content on Facebook, Instagram, and other social media platforms too have made a breathtaking leap. Whether it's a makeup tutorial or a trailer for an upcoming blog.
Do you find this interesting?
Role of video ads in fostering your brand image. People are spending.
Type interesting if you find it's interesting. So now what we are trying to do as a part over here, I'm going to show an example. The moment someone comes on my website, okay, so he has an option of hearing out everything or reading, else there is a small bot which says, do you want me to read an information for me? And this part, the moment he types yes, what happens is this chatbot, I'll just show you an example. So what's going to happen over here is, now this kind of chatbot will come, and then it will say, something like this. Okay, just for time being, I'm just reading it out for you.
Role of video ads.
So it says, hey, welcome to iKnowledge Factory Private Limited. We are a full service digital marketing agency. Thank you for visiting our website. So it looks like you had come down to my website from Australia because it detects an IP address. And good afternoon to you over there. So while you are browsing this particular thing on the website, don't forget to check out our client section. We are working with a couple of very amazing clients, and I'm sure you will find a couple of good references available there. The moment someone goes down to client page, okay, automatically that chatbot says, wow, it looks like you are following my instructions. So while now you are on a client page, let me tell you that we have serviced over 900 plus customers coming from manufacturing, education, real estate, healthcare, and multiple. So do you find this interesting? And imagine one thing, and the moment I click on this particular page, it will say, while there's everything being getting developed in an application era, so at IKEA, we do something like that. Do you find it interesting? So now this is a new innovation, what we are going to do. How do you rate it? How would you rate this particular initiative? And imagine one thing, how if we give you a small piece of a code, which you can put it up on your website and your website itself starts talking. Your website starts talking. Take an example. If today is one festive, say like, what's the festival? Holi. So it says, hey, welcome to Holi season. We all know that Holi is good for health, but before you do this, please ensure something. And here the content can be managed from one particular dashboard and saying that the moment customer comes to this page, read out this. Customer comes to this page, read out this. Do you find it interesting? Wonderful. Second thing, what I also want you to look up at it, okay, is all about communication, right? How influencing could be. So what we also did, apart from doing that, we also made a talking profile. Does customer ask you, by the way, say, please send me your company profile? Do you think your customer asks you, send me your company profile, I want to know more about you? And do you think when you send the company profile, it really opens? Do you think he opens up the company profile? You think it opens? Okay. But does it communicate the way you can communicate? If you call me and ask me to present, do you think my company profile will be able to present? So here is an innovation. When we said, why not we make a talking profile? Okay, so now this is how it looks. Just read it.
We live in a digital era. Digital era has empowered all of us to be highly expressive, impactful, and to converse with all our audiences more.
You are able to hear this?
So I thought, why not I create a walking, talking, and expressive video profile of IKEA? Hey guys, my name is Ashish Dalia. I run a digital branding and marketing agency by the name of iKnowledge Factory Private Limited. Have been in the industry for close
so to what I now, did, you know what is the cost of doing this?
We had a
couple of thousand rupees and the amount of time.
Over 450 plus.
So I'll just run it faster, okay?
Completed by one. Organization provide full service, search engine optimization, social media marketing.
So do you think, does it looks like as if I was standing and doing? Do you get a sense that it was as if I was presenting over there? How did you find this talking video profile? So now this is what it means that modern marketing always will be expecting some kind of an innovation from you. If you are not innovative, then you are a commodity. So if you really want to influence, so now take an example, the same PDF profile, I'll just share a link with you on this. I have Vrishali with me, she'll share a link of this YouTube video. Don't check it right now, else we'll send it to you later on. So now imagine one thing, that now this becomes my talking profile, which I can send to all my prospective customers, whom otherwise I would have met at exhibition, and to my databases. So imagine one thing now, when I have a data, I need to serve my data in a very, very different kind of a way. So that is what is marketing 4.0 is all about. So as we are discussing right now, what are the 9 approaches and arm of digital marketing? One is a website. Second is a social media. So Facebook, Instagram, LinkedIn, Twitter, everything is a part of that. Then comes is a search engine optimization. Because if you have a website, but if your website is not Google optimized, your website will be a digital brochure, but it will not be a sales machine. Today, my entire organization runs only on my website because only inquiry comes to me through a website. Any inquiry, if it comes to you through a website, will always be high potential. The reason for this being customer has searched you, they had researched about you, and then they are doing a business with you. So any inquiry coming down from your website or through digital platform where customer approaches you will always have a faster closing cycle. I'm repeating, fast closing cycle. Don't you want to have fast closing cycle? And our sales cost, marketing cost is zero. Because we don't do any cold calling. We don't visit. We don't put up any pamphlets. We don't put up any hoardings. We don't. Till now, I had not paid 500 rupees even for a single brochure. Everything available to me is on a digital platforms only. So this is a third avenue. Fourth is search engine marketing. Then is a blog and video blogging. So when we call it is ORM. So now any person, if they want to understand how good is about, so they can go and check out my reputation on Google, on Facebook, on Instagram. They will find there are so many and so many of the clients talking all positive about it. So if you just check out, you want to see what is ORM? How many of you want to see what is ORM? So I'll show you an ORM, okay? So ORM essentially means what is my reputation on IKF review. So when I type IKF review, essentially it means that what is a rating about me. So if you go on this, it says 238 Google reviews. So now these are the reviews which are about IKF and which talks what not. So now these reviews are being posted by real people, humans, and nothing can be better than this because people don't believe when I say, people believe when people about across talks about me. And when something of this particular sort starts coming up, it's almost 14 to 15 years of association with IKF has been wonderful or whatever, good experience working with the entire team. We had worked with IKF on some of the projects. So now what does that mean is all my sentiments, all my reputation is being managed by me. Managed by me is in the sense we are conscious about it. If my customer is happy about it, we ask customer to put it up over there. And when customer put it up over there, we don't know who's checking at what point of time. And when people check up at that point of time, and if they find positive reviews, do you think they will believe me? Is it good? Do you think it's good to have a better reputation on the internet? But you cannot build reputation by accident. You need to plan it out. If customer is talking about you, so whenever I go down to any of the customer, I have a standard template ready with me. Just take an example. So I take out this particular message to my client saying that it was absolute pleasure, delight working with. These are my predefined template. Okay. And I say, if you are happy with our services, please click on this link. When they click on link, a Google form opens up and then they can go and post their feedback about me. So you have to become conscious about it. Your customer is not going to search you and going to talk positive about you on the internet. He's got no bothers to do. Point is that if he's happy, it's your job to ensure that you document his sentiments on a Google because people check out your reputation on internet. Making sense? Do you believe what I'm talking makes sense for ORM? Perfect. And when reputation is good, when your reputation is good on internet, Google gives you top ranking. When you get a top ranking, people see you first compared to your competitor. When they see you first compared to your competitor and your website is professional, they will do a business with you. We all like to do business with a clean environment. So your website should be clean. Your website should be secure. Your website should be mobile compatible. Okay. Then is an affiliate marketing. This is a separate subject. So affiliate marketing essentially means that these days you can hire people online to make your sale and you have to pay them only at a time when a full transaction happens. Okay, it's a big topic, so I don't want to touch base on that. So if you are into B2C sale, you should seriously consider about affiliate marketing. Affiliate marketing is like, these are internet Amitabh Bachchan or Shah Rukh Khan, but they don't charge you for their visibility. They only charge you when a sale happens. Right? So get serious about affiliate marketing. Study on this subject. Else if required, sometime I'll take a full session on only on affiliate marketing. And then comes is a content marketing. On internet, if you're not producing content, you don't exist. Now, what is content? Content could be your videos, content could be your blogs, content could be your email, content could be your social media posts, content could be building up new connection, content could be writing up some feedback, or content could also be about getting reviews online. Okay, and start getting serious about email marketing and CRM. The cheapest mode of marketing today is email marketing. A platform like SendinBlue offers you to send 1,20,000 email just at a price of 4,000 rupees. Which platform? SMS is also costly, by the way. And with email, you don't have a limit. It will reach out if a mailing list with you is absolutely right. Okay, so now let's talk about new age customer behavior and modern marketing is like, if people see you, only then they believe. People in modern marketing, it's all transparent. Your reputation on internet has to be good. Your visibility has to be good. Your visibility has to be omni-channel. Only then people will buy from you. With modern marketing, turnaround time has to be faster. If you have to act fast. If you're not acting fast, there is a challenge with your modern marketing approach. Second thing is, new age customer is digital influence. If people are talking positive about you, they will believe you. If people are talking negative about you, they will believe them. And negativity sell much faster on internet compared to positivity. So that's the reason fundamentals like troll and all those things exist. This has to be research driven, because today's generation is research driven. They will compare your product, they will compare your services, they will compare your reputation, they will check your visibility, they will check your case studies, they will check your customer. So most of the time people have a website, but they don't update the website. So they are still showing up the old kind of client. And now if a new age customer comes, he says, oh my God, this is not appropriate. They are not yet updated. They will not do a business with them. Okay. Digital internet reputation, I spoke about it. Second thing is, I already told you, out of sight, out of mind. On internet, if you are not publishing, if you are not visible, if you are not consistent, no one will remember you. And then deploy customer retentionship management tool. Okay, this will help you to build up a reputation with your contact. Now with this COVID, what had happened is, social distance is a new normal. Physical meeting, physical interaction, face-to-face meeting, seminar, exhibitions is all off. No one is going to do that. So with, you will have to align all your businesses with a social distancing norm on a digital. A business decision over digital platform has started happening up. Today, if you all are seeing me on this particular platform, which means that people started adopting, learning, talking, discussing, servicing on a digital platform. Okay, business objective of digital is to cut down the cost. So take an example, if 70-80 people today attended this workshop, it was without any marketing person being given any salary, without any pamphlet, without anything. So objective of this is to cut down the cost, and the cutting down the cost can only happen through digital platform. Expand the horizon. Now today, if someone is from, we can see that lot, someone is from Switzerland, someone is from Hyderabad, someone is from Gurgaon, someone is from multiple cities. It's only because of digital. So we are able to expand a footfall, which means that more leads and more footfall will happen. So today we discuss about, your data is your king and your technology is your kingdom. King is, can only be protected in a kingdom. If king is out of kingdom, then he becomes a normal civilian. So please ensure that you use your data as per that. Second thing is marketing approach. We discuss about innovation, production and marketing. So post-COVID point is that marketing and production has to go through innovation. How you serve. So I told you about talking website. I spoke to you about a talking profile. So which means that it's eliminating me from going down to customer aid. Second thing is, learn to be faster and use technology. So probably last March, people were not very comfortable being on Zoom or on Google Hangout or on Skype, okay, compared to what they are today, because today we all know that socializing, even marriages are happening upon this particular platform. People are getting married and the invitation links are being circulated to check it out on Facebook Live and something like that. Okay, more tempting offer to engage a customer. Post-COVID matter is how do you engage customer, because customer today is a king like he was never ever before. And you have to be visible always. And then please plan out your customer onboarding strategy. If it says what got you here won't take you there. So what got your business to here will not take your business to there. What got your customer to your shop until now will not get your customer to come down to your shop if it's being shut down tomorrow. Okay, so how do we use technologies? Okay, so we use Google to search, right? So we use map, Google Map or Apple Map to find out a location. We use Ola and Uber to transit. We use YouTube and Netflix for entertainment and for learning. We use Amazon and Flipkart for buying. We use Paytm, Instamojo, PayU for payment gateway. We use Facebook, Instagram for social networking. We use LinkedIn for professional network. What do you see is a common in all this? A question to all of you. What do you see? We cannot live with any of this. Can you live without WhatsApp? Can you live without YouTube? Can you live without making a Paytm or Instamojo? So what is common? Yes, I'm looking out for more. Yes, continue. This is a time of brushing up. All this is marketing 4.0 tools and technology. So this is all marketing 4.0 tools and technology. Data is sitting, technology is delivering. Data is sitting, technology is delivering. Google data is sitting, their website is delivering. Map data is sitting, their tool is delivering. Ola and Uber data is sitting and their tools are delivering. Are you getting? Please repeat, data is sitting and tool is delivering. So you should also have a data sitting so that you can use tools and technology to deliver. Are you all with me? How would you rate your investment of time until now? 0 to 10. Please rate your investment of time until now. So understand one thing. The time when I asked you last time, how would you rate? The rating was 7. Today rating has gone down to 8, 9 and 10. Why? Because through digital platform, I am delivering you transparency, effectiveness, innovation. So imagine one thing, 15, 20 minutes back when I asked you, the rating was 7. Now average rating has come down to 8 or 8.5, whatever it is. So this is a power of a digital platform. You had not invested single money. I had not invested single money, but we are still able to, I am able to deliver and you are able to consume. Let's move on to next. So way forward for all of you is, please use social media platform to outreach your communication. Don't say social media is not for you. It's a time pass. It kills time, but understand one thing, that's a business. This is your new shop address. Please go to your shop daily. Otherwise, customer will come, they will find a lock and then they will move away. And I'm sure you don't want to do that, right? So social media, use social media to outreach your communication. This doesn't cost. Use Google to let customer discover you. So it is something like someone is going in a shopping mall asking for you, but they are not able to find you. So please ensure that you have a partnership with Google. You get your website, you get your local listing, you get everything linked up to Google so that new customer can. So when I said 80-20 rule, only 80% new customer will discover you if you are on social media and you are on Google. If you are not there, believe me one thing, nothing is going to change. Use LinkedIn to network with professional and identify new prospects. There are a couple of, I will take a separate session on LinkedIn marketing sometime. I'll send it out the information to you. But use LinkedIn to start interacting, talking to new sets of the people whom you want to network. Please use YouTube to let people hear you, launch your product, start giving your philosophy, start converting your PowerPoint presentation the way I did it on YouTube and upload it over there. Have customer read out your, just a minute, I'll just show you something. So how we use LinkedIn. How many of you are interested in understanding how we use LinkedIn, YouTube? We want to understand how do we use? So if you go down to YouTube channel of IKEA, you'll find it loaded with so many of the videos. So what are these videos? Try to understand over here. Here is my talk show. Here is my promotional thing. Here is my IKEA Women's Day campaign. Here's my talking profile. Here's my interview with my customer. Here is my upcoming video. Here is my another session, or here are the sets of other session I did. Here are my customer testimonials. Here is the culture of the IKEA. Here is Father's Day campaign, which is happening. Here is a Diwali. I'll just show you something over here. Very interesting what we do.
IKEA is a bunch of happy people. IKEA is a bunch of happiness culture. Happiness is everywhere at IKEA. Every moment we come across with each other, every celebrations we come across with each other, we ensure that we make most out of it. This day is no different. It's a Diwali vacation. We are heading for a Diwali vacation for almost for a week. So we thought, how can we make this? Stay tuned to check out the culture at IKEA,
so here the energy at IKEA, was a Diwali
and a passion at IKEA. Enjoy the day.
So that is what I am saying over here, that please use all this thing. Please use all these particular tools to the fullest of the extent, because investment done is one time, but the value you can create is multiple time. And YouTube don't charge, LinkedIn don't charge, Google don't charge, social media don't charge, Google local listing don't charge. Okay, it doesn't charge you to be put up over there. So who's stopping you? Okay, so please put up your stronger footprints on that. There are lots of CRM tools available which are free of cost. It could be like Sugar CRM or Sales CRM or Zoho CRM, and lots of tools are available. Please use these particular tools to ensure that you are 20 steps ahead of your competition. I'm not saying one step, 20 steps ahead of your competition. Than by force. So please start putting up thought processes in terms of adapting it up technically and digitally. Okay. So we have been using WhatsApp and SMS for instant messaging. We have been using Skype, Zoom, Google Hangout to meet and everything like that. So this was the evolution of marketing 4.0. I'll just run it faster. So earlier there was a company used to make a product and consumer didn't had any choice. So whatever was produced was to be required to be bought. That was the only choice available. But moving forward, consumer became king and he started demanding something. And then organization were having no other option other than servicing their requirement. So this is an era where marketing 2.0 got emerged. Then was an era of marketing 3.0, where brands started having people like Amitabh Bachchan or Akshay Kumar or Shah Rukh Khan to come and influence the decision of a buyers. Are you all up to me until now? I'm just running it faster. Marketing 1.0 was an era where product was being done and consumer didn't have choice. Marketing 2.0, where consumer was king and then organization were asked to demand, to supply the way consumer wanted. Then come was an influential era where celebrity, sports personality were being put up as a face of the organization. And then they were influencing the buying decision. Now this is an era of marketing 4.0. So who's influencing, by the way, marketing 4.0?
So you won't find marketing 4.0 is being influenced by any of the celebrities these days. So who are these? A question is to all of you. So who is influencing a decision maker over here? So who is influencing decision making in marketing 4.2? So let me cut short on this. So marketing 4.0 is being heavily influenced by your own digital footprint, your own behavioral on internet, the kind of mobile phone you use, the kind of internet you use, the kind of laptop you use, the kind of places you visit, the kind of video you watch, the kind of music you listen, the kind of website you browse, the kind of people are on your Facebook friend request. So these are a reason why you see a particular ad at any given point of time on Facebook, on Google, on YouTube, and on LinkedIn. So essentially, this is an era of you are selling it to yourself because your buying behavior, your personality is helping a brands and marketers like us to put our customer product in front of you. Had it been too lengthy message? You got the message clear? Did you got message clear? So you are marketing product to yourself because of your habits on internet. So if you have Ola app installed, if you have Uber or installed, if you have Paytm installed, if you are on Amazon, so what is, so one of the simple example is sometime when you go to internet, try to book a hotel and you see all the hotels, but you don't book up the hotel. What happens? For next couple of days, you see the same website is showing the same hotel at a discounted price. Because at that point of time, they might have shown you price of 10,000, but today they are showing you a price of 7,000 because they think at 7,000 or 8,000, you'll be able to buy. And that is a concept which is called remarketing. Concept is called remarketing, which means that you, your own footprint, so you are a salesman to yourself. Is this something new to you today, what I spoke to you? You are selling to yourself. Is this new to you today? Wonderful. So I think this is what your customer is also trying to do. This is what your customer is also trying to do. So your customer is available today. Your customer footprints are available today. Only thing is that now you need an intelligence of reaching out to him in an innovative format. Okay, so I will not talk too much on this. Okay, so I think by and large, I had covered up on this particular aspect any which ways. Okay, so now this is an important slide over there. So now when you want to do a marketing 4.0, so there are two kinds of businesses, okay? One is B2B businesses and second is a B2C. So let's look up at is what is required to be done at a B2B level and B2C. So if at B2C, you can take a screenshot of this if you want, okay? So B2B businesses should be stronger on their website because the decision making are being done through the website. They should be stronger on the social media front, that is the a social media front, let it be Facebook, Instagram, because it is a place of not just attracting a customer, but even for the prospective employer. Second thing is you should be rich on search engine optimization, Google AdWords and content marketing. Social media marketing. Remarketing is a concept where anyone visiting your website can be remarketed for next couple of days. You start using email marketing, start publishing content in terms of blogs, start deploying CRM at your organization so that you can communicate with your contact very frequently. Start using LinkedIn marketing so that you can understand what is happening across a professional network, your professional network. So who's changing a company, who's getting reward, who's getting recognized, because that's one of the reasons why you can open up a discussion with your prospective customer. So I'll take a separate LinkedIn marketing. I'll invite you all there. And then social media reviews are matters. Second thing I told you, affiliate marketing is there are lots of affiliates available on internet who are willing to sell your product on a commission basis. Secondly, for B2C marketing, social media matters a lot. Online marketplaces like Facebook, Flipkart, Amazon, Jio, Mart, and multiple other things matters a lot to be sold. WhatsApp is coming up with the marketing places. If you are seen, already WhatsApp has got a business WhatsApp where you can create a catalog, where you can publish a catalog and people can see all the catalogs from there. So please put up some time, understand what is business WhatsApp if you are not using. Email marketing use so that your customer don't forget you. Start using strong Google local listing so that people, when they're typing in for jewelry shop near me or mall near me or restaurant near me or what do you call this? Anything near me, okay? So that is the most trending search happening up today on Google. Be conscious about your Google review and these all things. So this is what we all discussed now. So benefits of marketing is, I think we already discussed on this particular part. Let me go. So what do you think digitally on a marketing 4.0 matters? Views, clicks, comment and shares. Yes, it does matter. But apart from this, your reputation, your recall value, your trust, your innovation in technology adaptation, your visibility and your consistency of doing this matters a lot. What do you see here? In next 5 minutes, we'll just wrap up. What do you see here? Could you help me understand what does this image replicate? Right. So being in the industry, I always believe one thing, that a bad website is like a flat tire. It exists, but it can't take you anywhere. A bad social media presence is like a flat tire. It exists, but it can't take you anywhere. A car without a tire will just be a liability to you. It will exist, but it won't take you anywhere. So it's a time right now to change a wheel and start moving, right? So are you all geared up to take it up to another level? Wonderful. So let's get onto some kind of a question answer thing. I just, so new age digital persona. So there was something which I wanted, but any which way. So now this is how we can help you. Okay. If anyone wants to understand who I am, who you are, what you should be doing, how good is your digital bandwidth right now, what kind of a digital platform you should be using, we can help you do that. We can help you understand what are the right mix of marketing 4.0 platform which will be useful to you, and from where to buy and how to start implementing it over there. Then comes this, we can help you to deploy CRM and the sales automation so that all the leads coming from various sources can be centralized at one particular location and you can control all the data rather than your sales executive. Because if tomorrow, if he changes the job, he changes a job, leaves you, goes to a competitor with the database which you had invested in hard for. So please be in a control of your own database. Second thing is, we can help you to do your competitor benchmarking, saying that what is your that your competition is doing right now. Okay, so this is my last slide of today, which is going to talk over here, saying that your knowledge is only good if you execute it. So acquiring knowledge is not a great thing. There is available amples and dozens. But point is that let's start taking small step by step and let's start winning it over the digital thing. Okay. So now, while there is so much of the news of lockdown and all those things happening up, my only thing which I would like to say you here is that don't be bothered by lockdown. Get ready to knock down. People are there. People are going to buy. People are going to consume the content. Point is that whether they will buy from you or not is a subject to be asked. So I will now stop my presentation. My only request would be, we can get active for 10-15 minutes on question answer kind of a zone. Let's adhere to one particular discipline. One particular person unmute themselves, ask me a question, and then please mute so that we will be able to take up the time. I generally believe in starting in time and ending up in time. Okay, so before I do this up, on a chat window, I'd like to hear from you all. How did you find an investment of your time? I'd like to hear from you all. So there are a couple of specific questions. Sunilji, what you do is check out later on, check out my profile, send me an inquiry, and my team will be able to reach out to you. We cannot talk specific on one particular subject. Okay, so I am giving an unwriting rights to everyone. So we are being joined by very prominent people also over here. Okay, so we also have Kirtiji. It's a pleasure to see you here, Kirtiji, if you can hear me.
Yeah, I can hear you.
Kirtiji, it was an absolute pleasure seeing you out here. In fact, having you itself is one of the great motivation for me.
I wanted to learn something from here. So yeah, it was nice to be here.
So Kirtiji, aap se bada brand to abhi humne dekha hai. Hum log to Shri Gopal ji Kabra se dekhte dekhte aage bade hue log hai. So in the interest of all the people, Kirtiji is a director of RR Kabel. जिनका ब्रांड एम्बेसिडर अक्षय कुमार है. कीर्ति जी, इफ यू कैन प्रोबेबली जस्ट शेयर योर एक्सपीरियंस कि कुछ चीजों को जो आप एडवाइस करना चाहोगे, क्योंकि आज आप जिस तरीके का बिजनेस ड्राइव कर रहे हो इंटरनेट के ऊपर, इनफैक्ट इंडिया के अंदर में और इनफैक्ट इवन ग्लोबली, तो आई थिंक यू आर अ लाइव एग्जाम्पल व्हाट इज दैट यू आर डूइंग राइट. आप अगर वीडियो ऑन करके अगर कर पाओ तो इट वुड बी अ ग्रेट प्लेजर. मैंने आपकी सिर्फ आज तक आवाज ही सुनी है.
ओके. या थैंक यू सो मच आशीष जी. मैं यहाँ पे एक्चुअली कुछ सीखने के लिए ही ज्वाइन की थी मैंने. सो ऐसा कुछ अलग नहीं किया है जो आपने नहीं बताया हो. यू नो इट्स ऑल सेट एंड वेरी क्लियर कट स्टेप्स विच यू नो यू नीड टू फॉलो. सो आई थिंक यू वेर बैंग ऑन एवरीथिंग एंड दिस इज वॉट वी आर एक्चुअली गोइंग अहेड विथ. सो not only internet but all 360 degree we are tapping. Okay. And that's what you know we are doing, and nothing really very specific I have here to mention.
So Kirti ji, aaj RR Kabel jo hai wo apne industry mein apne aap mein bahut bada leader hai. Akshay Kumar brand ambassador hai. Aapke aaj kitne sare countries ke andar mein production jata hai. तो अभी आपको क्या लगता है डिजिटल मार्केटिंग को लेके व्हाट स्टेप यू थिंक स्मॉलर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन शुड अडॉप्ट राइट नाउ?
सो राइट यू एज यू राइटली मेंशनड एक्चुअली इन द डिजिटल एरा ऑल अदर कन्वेंशनल अलोंग विद ऑल अदर कन्वेंशनल वेज ऑफ मार्केटिंग डिजिटल इज टेकिंग ओवर. So you rightly mentioned that, you know, people don't like to read. They want to hear. They want to listen. Video. Their attention span is reducing. Everything want it very easily. Yeah. And all these things will definitely work. You can connect with the world. You can connect with specific, very, very targeted audience. And you know exactly who is your audience. So all those things would help, but I would say that, you know, we are far away from, you know, targeting through only and only digital era. So, you know, the percentage may vary, but yeah, 360 degree is still required, at least in India, depending on your target audience.
Thanks a lot, Kirti ji. Aapka aana hi apne aap mein hum logo ke liye kaafi utsaah bhari cheez hoti hai. Thanks a lot. So anyone else out here would like to ask any question? Yeah, so forum is all open. We can have some kind of an interaction. Kisi ke kuch questions or kuch feedback ho to you can ask me and I'll be more than happy to address.
Sir, this is Parva Dave here. Can you hear me?
Yeah, I'll appreciate if you could show your video, put up your video on as well.
Sure,
yeah.
Sure.
And let's be precise with the question because I think there are lots of people on private chat also messaging me.
Yes.
I'd like to address. Yeah, please.
Can you see me?
Yeah.
My video is on. Okay. So my specific question would be the same which I have asked earlier. How to convince the top management about the ROI? What are the exact ROI with which we can convince to the top management? With these with these efforts, what kind of business we can project in our projections?
So I'll tell you most of the time what happens. I got your question.
Yeah.
I'll tell you most of the time it becomes difficult for an internal team to convince the top management because of the conventional thing. So that is where an agencies like us, an expert like us typically come in over there. And then we make a full device strategy to, जैसे मैंने आपको बताया था कि we can do a competitive review for you, we can help you understand कि आपका digital footprint क्या है, we can tell you what kind of a potential projection you can do it over there, and that's how the top end, because sometimes you require an external advices most of the time. तो घर पे अगर दादी बोलती है कि ये खा लो तो वो नहीं होता, लेकिन जब डॉक्टर बाहर से बोलते हैं तो हम लोग वो चीज करना चालू करते हैं. That is where the professional advices comes into the role. So most of the time in family-owned businesses hote hai, or traditional-owned businesses are there. So we are being invited to give up a pitch up over there. Because see, our job is that industry should start adapting it. Because only when industry start adapting is India will reach out to a potential where it is supposed to be.
Yes.
Okay, so most of the time you can set up the expectations with us and we can help you devise the right kind of a strategy. You just need to fix up our meeting with your top management. Before doing that also, we also evaluate, by the way, ki aapki company kya hai, kis bandwidth pe kaam karti hai, will you be able to afford also or not? Because most of the time, you have an intent of doing, but you might not be able to afford because of the smaller margins.
Yes.
So
yes.
We help you understand that.
Okay.
So you can always visit my website. I'll just put up my website.
But are there any ready-made or free tools which can just provide some info about having some projection or the strategy that by doing these things you might get this much of traffic to
See,
your website?
Go down to YouTube. There are ample of strategies available. It is like going to a chemist shop and saying that there is a bundle of medicines available.
Mm-hmm.
But what is right fitment for you is only a right doctor will be knowing. Pharmacist okay. will be just be a person who will be delivering it to you. So I'm saying when you are serious about it, always reach out to the right professionals over there, talk to them clearly, help them understand what are your challenges and let them come back to you because they are used to of handling this situation on a day-to-day basis.
All right. And after that, they can also provide that information which is usually asking by top management, what should be the ROI?
Yeah. So it's okay. Our kind of people are used to of it, what questions could be asked. Because that is what we have been doing for the last 20 years.
All right.
Most of the time, management also don't know what question to ask. We only tell them, "Aap shayad ye question puchna bhul gaye ho."
Yeah.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah. Anyone else over there? Yeah. So forum is open, and we have another 12 minutes. We will be here, and then sharp at 4:30, we will be able to close. 5:30, we'll close it down. So anyone, Pawan Bhattar, you are also there. So Pawan Bhattar, if you can unmute, and probably you are also one of the internet influencer. You are also into a life coaching, by the way. And I think you are also delivering quite a lot of content through this particular platform. So if you can hear me.
Thank you, Ashish bhai. This was a wonderful session.
Pawanji, we like
really
to
see amazing, a lot of
we like to see your face. Your face is equally important as your image.
I'm not sure how well visible I am.
You are
just wanted to tell you that this was a wonderful seminar, wonderful webinar.
So I think we are losing out in between.
And there are a lot of insights and a lot of
Yeah, please. So in the interest of all the members, let me tell you, Pawan Bhattar, who is with us, he is a world champion. He is a world memory champion. Okay, he is a fantastic trainer on training on memory power and also on how to read 100 books a year. Is being mentored by Tony Buzan, right? Tony Buzan, right?
That's correct.
Tony Buzan, who is a mind championship out here. Thanks a lot, Pawanji.
My pleasure. Thank you, Ashish bhai.
Yes, thank you.
And I have known IKEA for a long time, and you are doing a lot of wonderful work. I know you have a lot of happy customers, and I think I've been following you for almost 10 years or so by now.
Thank you. I think rather than doing a social service, I think delivering knowledge itself is a big CSR. So a lot of people come to me for CSR. And I say, if I am able to circulate my knowledge, I think that itself is a bigger CSR. Thank you, Pawan. You
absolutely. We call it knowledge philanthropy.
Thank you. Yeah. Anyone else over here? I'd like you to self-nominate and please ask up the question. So quite a lot of people, when they ask me ki kya karte ho, I said company chalate hain, wohi apne aap mein bahut bada CSR, and I rather prefer to give my time to an enterprising community right now to share my knowledge so that they grow their businesses. And the entire objective of this was basically just to share with you whatever is my learning of 20 years. And as I told, I am not the expert on this. Whatever I knew it in small pinches and bits of it, I just wanted to open it out with you all. Thank you. Yeah. So if we don't have any questions, then in another 1 minute, we can just close and we can start leaving then. So Sitrali, you are asking me, please suggest CRM. So there are multiple CRM. So which CRM will be right for you and your industry is something which you will have to probably discuss with us in one-to-one or probably with some of the consultant so as to understand what are the right CRM platform. There are tons of the CRM platform available, but it all really depends upon what kind of a right platform you should be using. So Satish, you are talking about, kindly guide me on generate leads. So generating lead is a very generic level of the topic. It really depends upon which industry you are into, what kind of a product you are into, what is the geography you deal into, and multiple such kind of a thing. So that would be pretty generic level question. So sometimes I have just put down my website address over there. Okay, you can visit, drop in an inquiry, and someone from my organization will help you understand all that. So we have a separate customer service department who can help you understand what are the things, and not every engagement needs to be commercial. Point is that we want you to be successful. So you invested 2 hours with us. It's your trust, what you have built up. You are a part of our community now. So we want to ensure that you are using this power to the maximum level. Thank you. So Fortini, I hope you got what you expected.
Yes, thank you very much. Very informative, innovative, and inspiring. A lot of research to do and thinking. So absolutely. Thank you very much.
Absolutely. So what I just shown you today is just a name of a cover page of a book. There are multiple chapters. There are multiple pages within that. Option is either you become an author, else buy some author's book and start implementing it. So I always look up at it in two things. One is that doing or not doing is no more option. You have to do it. Now, whether you should do it or you should hire an agency to do it is another thing. And generally people ask me, should I do it in-house or should I outsource? I always say one thing, either you have time or you have money. So whatever you have, invest that. If you have time and no money, invest your time and get it done. If you have money and no time, hire an agency and get it done. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. So thank you everyone. Then we can close out this session and you can start leaving up the group, and I will be the last one to be leaving. Thanks a lot for having a faith, and thank you Lord. Thanks a lot for joining this session. We look forward to see you grow up your business on this digital revolution, digital wagon, digital Airbus, and whatever you want to call. Thank you.